out them city slickers' arm. But that Christmas Eve, they heard something they'd never heard before.
It was a story.
So really, this is a story in a story.
And it all happened in the country.
What are we doing here? Out in the middle of nowhere, miles away from civilization?
I don't want to spend Christmas out in the sticks.
Like we have a choice.
But if Dad can't get the car fixed in time, we're stuck here for the holiday.
I hate this. There's nothing to do out here. No video games, no Netflix, not even a TV.
There's not a mall or a movie theater within 100 miles of here. I'm bored stiff.
These people were nice to let us stay here, I guess. But what's with them? They call everybody cousin.
Yeah, that's weird.
The next time somebody comes up to me and says, howdy, cousin.
Howdy, cousin.
I think I'll be sick.
Sick, cousin Nathan, are you ailing?
Not exactly.
I'll have Granny get you down some casserole. It'll fix you up in a jiffy.
No, for me, please. I'll be okay. Really.
If you say so.
Hey, Cousin Daniel, you want to go down to the creek and catch crawdads?
No, I mean, it sounds like a blast, but I think I'll pass.
Hey, Cousin Chelsea.
That's just Chelsea.
Oh, sorry, just Chelsea. You want to go climb the persimmon tree?
No thanks. I'm not dressed for climbing.
I have some overalls you can wear. They're my Sunday pair. But I don't care if you wear them.
No, I think not.
Alrighty.
Hey, cousins, you wanna?
No!
Alrighty.
Look, Luther, for me. We don't want to be rude, but Chelsea and I feel, well, a little misplaced here out in the boonies. We'd like to get back to the city before Christmas.
Yeah? What's so special about the city anyhow?
It's so cool. There's always something to do.
Things are really happening, you know? This is how Christmas is in a city.
Going to the mall.
Don't you ever get together with your families at Christmas Eve?
Not really. Normally we go to a boring office party with my parents.
That's where we were going when the car broke out.
So y'all don't gather around the Christmas tree and sing the Christmas story?
The Christmas story? Like, 'twas the night before Christmas?
No, the Bible story. And it came to pass that them days there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus.
I've never heard that Christmas story.
Me neither.
It's from the Bible.
Every Christmas Eve, we get to see the tree and decorate it with popcorn and cranberries. And Uncle Yule reads a Christmas story.
Ooh, exciting.
Uncle Yule? What kind of name is that?
It's short for Yuletide. See, he was born on Christmas Day, just like Jesus.
Like Jesus?
I don't know about that. And I still don't believe you have an uncle named Yuletide.
In the flesh and at your service.
Uncle Yule.
Howdy, Uncle Yule.
Heard we had company. Some cousins or something.
We're not cousins.
This here's Cousin Daniel and Cousin Chelsea.
That's just Chelsea.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Just Chelsea.
They're gonna be spending Christmas.
Oh, please no.
Nice to make your acquaintance, youngins. Your mom and pa here too?
Yes, our parents are here. Somewhere.
Dad's been trying to get someone to fix the car.
Which may be impossible on Christmas Eve.
And Mom's been nursing a migraine.
What about y'all from?
We're from the city.
Well?
Our car broke down, and now we're stuck here for the holiday. And now we might miss Christmas altogether.
Well, we have Christmas out here too, you know. Of course, we do have to order the air and the sunshine from the Sears and Roebuck catalog. But we do have Christmas.
That's a good one.
It may be Christmas time here, but it won't really be Christmas like it should be.
Well, I don't know about that. But Christmas is a country holiday.
What?
Well, yeah, sure. Christmas started out in a little old country town called Bethlehem, which means house of bread. From the sermon this morning. Group up here, youngins, and I'll tell you all about it.
Country in a little country town. Country.
Well, we like it.
So, now what?
How about if you render us a tune?
Render a tune? Oh, you mean sing a song?
I don't know. Our music wouldn't translate out here. You wouldn't understand it.
What kind of songs do you sing, cousin?
Yeah, they like the songs that we sing?
Not at all.
Very different.
Different? Like how?
Well, okay. Our Christmas songs sound cool.
Jingle bell, jingle all the way. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle all the way. Jingle bell.
Of a bunch of shepherd boys ascending on the hillside.
Bye, youngins. Yeah, kids, there's hog jaws and turnip greens and even Mexican cornbread. Granny's Mexican cornbread really swings my bugs.
Come on, Cousin Daniel, Cousin Chelsea.
You can sit by me.
I don't need my buds twanged. Thank you.
Me neither.
After we eat, we're going to decorate the cedar tree, and then Uncle Yule's going to read the story from the Bible.
No thanks.
All right, suit yourself. Come on, gourmet.
Help! We've been adopted by the Clampets.
What are we going to do, Daniel? I'm starving! And who knows when we'll get out of here?
There's hog jaws and cornbread. Just waiting to twang your buds.
Oh, Daniel, I don't think I can take it anymore. All this cornpone talk and cousin this and cousin that. I've got to get back to civilization.
Me too.
I think I'm going to cry.
Hold on a minute. We were taking a selfie. Youngins, the Beatles is getting cold. And wait a minute. What are you bawling for?
Chelsea is, homesick.
Well, I guess everybody don't take to our country cooking and country ways.
I'm sorry. I don't mean to hurt your feelings, but the Boonies just aren't me.
Well, I understand that. You didn't exactly fit into our plans either. Kind of like that first Christmas, I reckon. Yeah, it's bad enough the King of Kings been born in that one-horse town called Bethlehem, which means house of bread. But for him to sleep his first night in the barn, people had a hard time accepting that.
Is that really the way it was?
It really was. And that was God's plan all along. Caught the rest of the world off their guard, though. They didn't know what to think about it. It might surprise you what you find out here in the boonies. You youngins like peanut butter and jelly?
Yeah.
Sure.
Well, come on in here. I know a good old recipe that'll set you right up.
Thank you.
about celebrating Jesus' birthday. But there they was, city slickers, with all their city thinking, not knowing the real Christmas story. It was like a mystery novel or something. The more they heard, the more they wanted to hear. Yep, and they didn't never try the hog jowl at the granny's table, but over a glass of milk and a peanut butter sandwich, they got an earful of the gospel.
You know, Uncle Yule, I think peanut butter and jelly taste better in the country.
You don't say.
Yeah, and country milk's gotta be better for you than the kind we get in the city.
I probably think it is.
Uncle Yule, we're really sorry we kind of made fun of all the country stuff.
Yeah, we're sorry. I know this isn't the city, but it's not so bad. In fact, it's kind of quiet and peaceful.
And everybody's real nice.
Say, Uncle Yule, do you think you could read us the Christmas story one more time?
All right. Hey, cousin, your pa just called. He got your car fixed. He'll be here directly to pick you up.
Now you can get back to the city and call for Christmas.
Yeah, great.
Cool.
Cousin Daniel, you don't act excited. What's wrong?
Yeah, I thought you're all fired up to get back to the city, Cousin Chelsea. I mean, just Chelsea.
It's okay, Cormace. You can call me cousin if you like.
You mean it?
Yeah, I mean it.
Chelsea, you think Dad would let us stay long enough to decorate the tree and hear the Christmas story again?
I think so. I mean, I reckon.
Tell me about your mother and her holy.
and decorate the tree and hear the Christmas story again.
In fact, their Pa and Ma seemed to enjoy themselves too.
Their Dad forgot about the office party he was missing.
And their Ma forgot about her headache.
That night, they all gathered around and Uncle Yule prayed, thanking God for bringing them all together.
And then City Slickers heard the real Christmas story for the first time.
You know, it's hard to believe that there are people out there who don't know the true meaning of Christmas.
I reckon there's somebody here who ain't heard it. Or somebody who needs to hear it again anyways.
And so, let's tell it again.
Yeah.
Uncle Yule, but this whole time I thought Granny was my wife. I don't know. You know, anything can happen out in the boonies. I don't know. But we're all probably related here somewhere. But let's give these kids another round of applause. Y'all want to come out here and take a bow?
Yeah.
Come out here and do one of those things. There we go. Let them come out here. Go up there and do a bow, kids. It was really good. I think they did a really good job, and I'd like for you give a round of applause to Daniel Abernathy and everybody else who helped build this construct here. And now I want to ask my youth leaders who work tirelessly, Erica and Julie included, even Carol Robinson, you helped too. But y'all stand up and let's give them a hand clap. Congratulations.